payments for 90 days and $500 additional bonus cash for the rest.
Hello, everybody. I'm back. You're probably sick and seeing me. So I just want to welcome you to Tip Tuesday tonight. So tonight is going to be a shorter call, and I'm going to walk you through an actual roadmap to success that the company just released. It's for people that just started and they're in their 90 days, but it also can be used for those of you who are looking to jumpstart your business, restart your business. We all go through what I always say are peaks and valleys of the business. You know, no matter what season you're in, whether you know it's your season of life, the season for the time of year, there's always going to be peaks and valleys. Okay, so you have to think about any other store out there. Stores go through periods where they have their highs and their lows. Okay, they have the different seasons of busyness and lacking business. So I always say May is always going to be one of the hardest months, kind of April and May. They kind of go together, usually picks up a little bit more at the end of May after Memorial Day. But here is why. I'm going to tell you what I've discovered in the 4 years of business. Is number one, anybody that has kids that are in any sports, so that is ranging from basically age 3 to age 18 or even college level. If they have kids, this is a transitional period for sports, which means most sports teams do not have schedules because this is, I hate to say it, but sometimes ran by men, so it's not always out there with dates. So us women are very diligent. We would have a schedule. A lot of people are waiting on dates. Graduation, anybody that has family members graduating from college, people that are graduating from high school, end of the school year. PSSAs took place in April, so a lot of times people won't commit to things during the week because if their kids had to go to sleep earlier. I know dance classes are picking up this time of year because they're getting ready for recitals. You are in a competitive time of year for anybody that has children. Okay. So that number one, April and May, this is why I always learn you got to really book ahead when it comes to like February and March to fill your April and May extra. So you'll learn this for next year. So then that way you're not fumbling because this is a tough time. So here's my tip for you tonight. Number one is you're going to focus this month on booking parties with people that have older children, you know, maybe people that already have kids that have great, or even have grandkids. You're going to focus on people that are just out of college, people that are younger, that are maybe not married yet, maybe just got homes, people that maybe are married, but they're newlyweds. They don't necessarily have children yet. These are going to be great age groups to focus on this time of year because there's not that school commitment of craziness going on and sports schedules that you're going to compete with. This is the problem. This time of year, people won't commit to you, okay? It doesn't mean when they tell you no, it doesn't mean that they mean no to you and you take it to heart. I've always learned in the business, if somebody tells me no, I always come back with a second, well, is, you know, I know this obviously this time seems very hectic for you. Would July or August work better? So when somebody says no, we come back with an option for them because sometimes when you tell somebody immediately, they think that they have to do it right now. So then they panic and instantly say no. So give them the opportunity to pick a different time of year. Or say, you know, if home parties don't work for you, would a virtual or just even passing catalogs around at your work work for you as well? So always giving them an opportunity and always coming back with a second question so that it's not just a no and that we take offense. If somebody does not answer you on Facebook or a text message, it does not count as your contacts. So when we say 5 contacts a day, it means 5 actual conversations. Some other things that you might be willing to do this time of year is ask moms if they want to do a quick party, a quick grill party at the baseball field. That's always something fun that you could do. Fundraisers. Now in May, we are going to be supporting the American Cancer Society. And we're going to be supporting it in a different way this year. And I'll be going over a lot of those details coming up. But they're going to be supporting the Hope Lodge. So for people's families to go and stay at the different lodges. And I know Connie's looking into maybe us doing a team event at one of the Hope Lodges, where as a team, we can actually meet at different Hope Lodges, depending on where we're located, and maybe prep meals and help them with stuff like that to get our names out there, obviously offer our time. But running tons of fundraisers. So anybody affected by cancer, you know, see if people will jump on board with you and do some cancer fundraisers to raise money for the Hope Lodge in May. That's a great way for you to pick up your business as well. Fundraisers for sports teams, reaching out to any summer sports, any type of baseball associations. I know they're always looking for different fundraisers. So are usually soccer. So sometimes the soccer organizations will start for the fall already too. I would also recommend in May hosting cooking classes at your house. We're going live more frequently because you're going to create desire. But also if you do cooking classes, don't look as doing cooking classes for profit. Look at it as a way of helping people in their kitchens. Because if you do a cooking class at your house, chances are you're going to be making recipes that people are going to like, and they're going to get their hands on the products, and it's going to give you an opportunity to get your name out there. Working with any type of community art centers, you could run some type of kids cooking classes. June is a great time to run kids, even like a kids cooking camp at your house. And I have like even liability forms I've created over the years that if anybody's interested, or if you partner with any kind of community art center to do things or churches, you could do Girl Scout cooking classes, kids cooking camps in the summer. These are some things that will help to fill your calendars in a completely different way. Also meal prepping, teaching people how to meal prep. So again, it's not going to be a party, but what's going to happen is you're going to create the desire and people end up booking to get those products, or they're going to be placing orders at these events. One of the things I did when I first started my business is I ran kids cooking classes twice every month. I ran a cooking class at my house every month, and I would run freezer meal workshops. And I'm not going to lie to you, I did not always make profit, but it was to get my name out there and to build a clientele so that people knew that they can count on me. So sometimes it's not about the almighty dollar, because what happens is it comes back tenfold. So there's some quick tips for you for this time of year. The other thing you could do is a Memorial Day challenge where people go out and collect $200, and then you could give them a product that they want at 60% off or, you know, discount. But if you make it kind of a Memorial Day challenge or a Mother's Day challenge, you know, that we could earn mom free gifts, you can get creative with that. But there are some things that also you could do to get some sales on your for your commission and stuff for this month. So like I said, do not get down. June will pick up like crazy. And I'm going to tell you right now, do not tell anybody the June special at all until literally the last month or the last week of May. If you tell them the June special, you tell them it's top secret, because once it leaks, you're never going to have a May calendar filled at all, because everybody's going to want double free money in June. As soon as you talk to people and tell them it's double free money, even those people that are naysayers that say, I'm not really interested. And then you go, but you can get double free money this month, and explain to them how it works, you will have a full calendar in June. June is always one of my craziest months, and so is July, because up until July 15th, I sneak in the June special of the double free money. I just make sure I always close everything out by June 13th in case credit cards decline. I have no issue, so I always cut it off July 13th. June and July, if you really dedicate yourself to this time, you will have amazing sales these months. And I'm not going to lie to you, May is the hardest month of the year for me. So is August. And I'm going to tell you why. It's school time. It's kids. And anybody that has kids and they're in that period of their life, this is what's going to happen. So it's a matter of you taking your energies and focusing them in different areas to network the right groups of people during this time. So one of the things that we're going to be focusing on tomorrow night when we do our recipe night, I'm going to be doing a Zoom challenge of listing 100 people's names. And what we're going to also work on is splitting up as the food's cooking or as we're eating to come up with a bunch of different networks of people for May that we can reach out to and groups. So that way we kind of say, oh, okay. Oh, I'm looking at, the church ladies, you know, that maybe cook in the churches. Oh, I can reach out to Betty Sue and Betty Ann or, you know, whoever. But then that way we have a list that we can go through and say, okay, well, these people are not necessarily groups of people that currently have children in that age group that would affect our businesses. Because it's just a matter of us getting creative. In the summer, when if people are crazy busy, do mommy and me parties, do grilling parties. You know, you got to come up with the verbiage to make it appealing to people. Instead of just saying, do you want to have a party or do you want to have a show? You got to offer them something so that they are interested in taking advantage of what you have to offer. Okay. And I will be posting some more information on that. Now, what I wanted to share with everybody tonight, I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. This will only take me a couple minutes. My house is crazy. We are not adjusted to time schedules or being back right now. So I don't even have bath time now right now. So bear with me here, because I just have to. So we are adjusting in some ways being back. And in other ways, I feel like my head is spinning. So bear with me. All right, let me just find my screen and share it with everybody. Okay, so the screen that I'm going to share, okay, there it is. Okay, so this screen that I'm sharing is called the Road to Reward. So this was actually physically designed from Pampered Chef, and I will be posting this on the team page. So anybody that's in your first 90 days, I want you to print it off. And if you're not in your first 90 days, I want you to print this off. And I'm going to tell you why. The reason being is it doesn't matter where you are in your business. Now, there's going to be some parts of this that are not going to hold true for you.
What?
Because you're not going to be getting extra Pampered Chef dollars if you're not in your first 90 days of business. But this is what I always taught people to try to do when you want to jumpstart your business.
On top of the slow cooker.
Because I'm not going to lie, this is the time of year that I tend to slack off in my own personal business. And it's because of my schedule and my kids' schedule, and I get neglectful. So I've learned to book my parties ahead of time, but I still always end up in a slump for my May parties because I book like crazy for April and then I get tired. I don't know. It's just how I am. And I don't want to be that way. So I've learned a little bit to be better, but this is always the time of year I jumpstart my business. I kick everything off in May, put my butt to work, and I get started again for my, you know, basically like in 90 days, which is puts you through almost the summer. All right, because what's going to happen is if you follow this road to rewards, it's also going to lead you into a great deal of success to put you into the busy selling season, which is our fall. The fall is amazing, as long as you set yourself up properly and book shows. So if you look at the starting point here, it's talking about your first 30-day goal. So whether this is your first 30 days or you're just kickstarting it again, you want to try to hit, again, you want to make a goal for yourself to hit 12, 15 sales in your next 30 days of business. So starting April 24th, 30 days from now, you want to work on hitting 1250 in sales. You also, what they recommend is to have one qualified recruit. So what does this mean? Well, they're saying share your new business. So if you're new, obviously that's what you're going to do. If you're not new, it means promoting your business. So maybe going live with your spring products, maybe going live to talk about the Hope Lodge, things like that. Then it says book and hold your first parties. Again, this is if you're starting new, I always recommend to do 4 parties within your first 48 hours. Beyond that, what I always tell everybody to do is you want to book at least 8 shows a month. If you do not have 8 shows on your calendar right now, have no fear. You're going to reach out to people and you're going to work towards it. If you have 4, it still means that you have 4 more than you had before. And your goal is always to reach the 8. So just keep working at it. Just because it's the, you know, we could have a week left in the business. Like I'll tell you right now, like I booked 2 parties to start tomorrow. I booked them yesterday. So it doesn't matter how much time is left in the month. You could literally book a show the last day of the month and say you're doing an hour long virtual and close them that night. All right. So I always tell everybody, you're not done until it hits 1 a.m. Chicago time on the end of the month. You know, so you have a whole week yet to get business in April and to work on booking your May. Get to know your products. Most of you already know your products. Some of you are product junkies. So some of you know this, and this is an area you know well. If you are not familiar with products, this is very important because I always tell people I'm not a saleswoman. I know my products and I educate. So the teacher in me goes out and teaches people about my products and how it can benefit them. So by showing products and giving them a lot of options on how you can use it is going to make for, you know, basically to show people that they're going to benefit from owning that product and it's going to create the desire. So an example is the wok. Right now, a lot of people think, oh, it's a wok. It's for stir fry. Teach them that they can make a quiche. Teach them that they can put it in the oven. Teach them that they can make cakes in this. You know, there's a lot of other versatility to that pan other than just using it as a stir fry wok. So give them options and allow them the opportunity to explore by hosting a cooking show with you to learn the different ways, show them, you know, versatility, or by making sure that they know different options that they have with the pan. You know, a lot of people might not realize that they can stick that pan in an oven. Obviously making sure that they're also aware that they want to have good hot oven mitts to hold heat so that when they get the handle out, it's going to be really hot. Things like that. But making sure that people are aware of the products and their benefits.
Oh, that's a,
and like then inviting a friend to join your team. This does not always come easily, and this does not always come immediately. The idea of the business is really truly that you offer the business to everybody. And it does not mean you're going out looking for recruits. It's simply saying something along the lines is, you know, are you interested in hearing more about the business opportunity? This is what it's done for me, and this is what it can do for you. It's not up to us to decide. It's up to them to decide. So what they always tell us is share the business with everybody you meet. If they are not interested in the business, you could always ask them for a referral of somebody that might be, because obviously the goal is to benefit other people in the world. And if they still are not interested, you could always ask them. That's when it opens up the door and the opportunity for you to work on hosting something for them. And I always try to tweak my wording when I ask people for shows. I try not to ask them to book a party or host a show. I try to let them know that I would love to come and pamper them and their friends for a night. I'd love to come and give you a break so that you and your girlfriends can socialize, and I'll teach you some great recipes. Or, you know, you seem like you've been really stressed at work lately. I would love to come and do a girls' wine, cheese, and chocolate night for all of you. You know, focus on something that's going to benefit them, and they're going to be more willing to want to have a party. Because remember, it's about them. It's about giving them the opportunity to get together with friends. If it's online, it's giving them the opportunity to earn some great products for their kitchens and help their friends and family do the same. If you're asking them, to, you know, if you're sharing about the business with them, you know, telling them ways that it might benefit them as well. You know, we can give you a couple extra $100 to pay off your car payments. Maybe we'll give extra money for dance class for your daughter every month. Everybody is in need of money in some aspect of their lives. There's nobody so wealthy that they're going to be like, nope, sorry, I don't need money. You know, so you never know when the right time is going to come. And when you offer the opportunity to people, they may not say yes right now. They may blow you off. They may not even answer you or respond to you. But when you offer the opportunity, you open a door that there's a chance they may come back. And I always say this with bookings as well, because realistically, when you plant the seed, it's like watering a flower. It's like watering a seed. You put the seed in the ground. You're going to water it by informing them about the opportunities, whether it's booking or joining your team. Then you're going to keep, you know, they're going to see your videos. You're going to chat with them more. You're going to build your relationship. And eventually it will blossom. And whether they choose to book a party, join your team, or just be your customer, it's not going to matter. You're building that relationship. So the seed will eventually grow. I've had people that have been at my parties over 4 years. I've had people at 6 and 8 parties, and they never hosted their own parties. But they've always been a reliable customer. Or I've had people that have come to 5 and 6 shows, and all of a sudden then they book a party. So you just never know when the timing is going to fit or when the product is going to be in front of them that they really desire. So these are quick start 30 days. So I'm going to challenge everybody to work on doing these things in the next 30 days of your business, because this is going to set you up then for the following 30. So it says, congratulations, if you hit your 30-day goal, you would get $200 Pampered Chef. Now, of course, this goes along the lines of if you are a new consultant. If you're in your first 90 days and you hit $1,250, they're going to keep giving you $100 every time you do that. But more importantly, the next tab is where I feel is most important for you at this level too, is even if you're not in your first 90 days and you're kind of restarting your 30 days, you're going to make $287 in commission. That's more than a part-time job is going to offer you, and it's under your own flexibility and your own schedule. So to me, this puts complete control in your life, and it gives you extra money in your pocket for whatever you choose to do. Now, if you are booking your 8 parties and inviting a friend to join your team in your first 30 days, what's going to happen is it's going to set you up for more parties within that 60-day time frame, so the next 30 days. So then what they tell you to do is they want you to keep booking your parties, because obviously that's what we do. Now, one of the main things I would suggest is booking parties from parties you currently have, working with your host, doing some type of game at your parties. If you are struggling to get bookings from your parties, please reach out to me. I will always help you, and I always match effort for effort, because I always tell everybody, I'm not going to be pesky because we're all adults. I want to support you. I want to be your cheerleader, and I want to help you to be successful. But everybody has different needs and wants. So if you say, Vanessa, I really need help in this area, or Vanessa, I really want to learn more about this, absolutely, I'll design a training. I'll work with you one-on-one. But like I said, everybody, it's so much that we can cover. So I would absolutely get on personal calls with anybody, and I'll help you. You know, if you need help with getting parties from your parties, if you currently have a blank calendar and you're struggling for your May, let's brainstorm. I'll help you brainstorm, and we'll come up with some ideas and ways for you to network. And then, of course, if we spend that time together, I am going to ask you to make sure you work on that and you're following through on the action steps of that. Because I know from doing the business in the last 4 years, if you make a plan and you follow through on action steps, there's always success. You know, it's when we get negligent sometimes. And in the beginning, I was one that would say, well, I contacted everybody I know. But then when I really sat back and looked at it, I'm going, well, I contacted everybody I thought might say yes. And in my mind, I'm like, well, I contacted, you know, 15 people. But in reality, I didn't contact everybody I know, because of course, let's face it, we always get things from more people or ask for referrals. And then what I was discovering is I was stopping myself from reaching goals because I wasn't asking enough people. So that's the thing you want to keep in mind, is you're going to ask a lot of people when you do direct sales, and that's okay. So you might ask 80 people in 1 week instead of 25, But guess what? Maybe this month is crappy, but then all of a sudden in June, 40 of those people come back and want to book a party. That sounds a little bit high, but the reality is you plant the seed and then you don't know where it's going to lead you. So that's the idea of asking everybody. Now, the other thing is, with it, what the company recommends is always inviting your host to join your team. So these are going to be some of your first recruits. If people are hosting parties with you, it means that they like the products. It means that they might be product junkies already, or it may mean that they would really love to get discounted items at all times. So sometimes people will join your team because they want the discount. Sometimes people join it because they want extra money. Sometimes people join it because they want, you know, more in their lives. Maybe they want vacations. They're going to join for a lot of different reasons. And that's why it's important to always offer it. One of the things you can do early on is before you actually even host the party. And I'm going to tell you, this is what actually I did in the beginning. I was very scared to do. I never asked my host because I was always afraid that my calendar would be empty. Because of course, if they joined my team, well, then they would get their own bookings. And what I want to assure you is it's okay for that to happen. And people get scared to ask people to join the team that are local. And that's what a lot of people locally will say to me, well, Vanessa, you shouldn't ask people locally. And I'm like, why wouldn't I? You know, there's a McDonald's every 5 miles. It doesn't mean that McDonald's can meet everybody's needs, even in a 25-mile radius. You know, same with Walmart's, you know. So we are no different. We're just a traveling store, and our traveling store offers quality service and customer service and relationship building. So when it comes down to it, there are going to be people that maybe did business with me and may go to somebody else if somebody else joins our team. But that's okay because I'm one person. And eventually what happens is you want that network to grow so that you do have other people, because then your customers are always going to be satisfied. And when they join your team, you're going to get an override. So you're still benefiting and helping these people. You know, so don't be afraid to invite people. Now, the other thing is when you invite your host to join your team, you might want to start out with saying something as simple as, I wanted to talk to you about the business. Were you interested in setting up your party to be your launch party? Because if you'd like to set it up as your launch party, we could turn your party into your own party as a consultant. If they say no, then again, you can mention it when you get to their house or when you're doing their virtual party. And then at the end, making sure you offer them the kit credit to remind them that when their party reaches $400, they have a kit credit, or $300, I apologize. $300, they have a $25 kit credit. $400 up, they can use $50 of their free money. So making sure you offer that to them, because a lot of times your host will become your consultants on your team and become some of your best friends. Connect with your customers to see if they need anything, reaching out. You know, it's always a good time. You could always reach out at any given time, give a recipe on the products, tell them a tip about their products. And again, if you do these steps in your next 30 days or the first 60 days, you're going to make another $287 in commission or more in Pampered Chef dollars. And then the 90-day plan is, if you're 90 days again, whether you're new or not, again, still set yourself up to accomplish this. I'm going to challenge you to print this sheet out and put a sticker over each step and work towards each of these spots in this roadmap. And when you do it, sticker it. Because if you complete all of this, I will absolutely offer you Pampered Chef dollars or a prize. I will be giving out Pampered Chef dollars for our bookings. I'm waiting on some of the leaders still to send me the booking blitz screenshots. But I will absolutely, if you finish all of this and you book your parties and you're reaching your commission levels and you're adding team members, absolutely, we will celebrate your success. So that's what we're here for. We want to celebrate you. So in your 90-day plan, you want to, again, submit another $1,250, okay? So realistically, this is submitting $1,250 in sales a month. And what is this doing for you? It's definitely guaranteeing you at least a $287 paycheck. And in addition to this, you are also going to earn the monthly sales incentive all the time for the company. So that's another bonus with this as well. Now, of course, if you're in your first 90 days truly a business, you're going to get your Pampered Chef dollars as well. So when you're looking at the 90-day plan, they want you again to continue to fill your party. See, what I always tell everybody is this is a simple process, okay? It's really not rocket science. Anybody that earns trips, anybody that has success, the only difference between those in the business that are successful and those that are not are the people that quit and give up. So if you consistently reach out to 25 people, true contacts a week, you book 8 parties a month, and you invite 2 team members every month to join your team, well, actually, not just invite them, but actually they join your team, your business will always grow. And that is truly what this business was designed on from our very beginning. So this is nothing that is going to, you know, there's no secret. This is exactly what you do. And this will help you to be successful, okay? And if you start off at 4 parties, then that's fine. You know, you all, everybody has their own goals in mind. Maybe your goal isn't to make $300 a month. Maybe your goal is to make $100 a month. We all have our own goals. And the idea here is I want to help you reach whatever goal you have. So this is a roadmap to success from our company. If you are doing, you know, half of each of these, there's going to come a point probably in your business where you're going to want to take it to the next level. And that's where you're going to go from your 4 parties to your 8 parties. Or you might even take 8 parties and go to 12 parties. You know, sometimes people go from 12 parties to 24 parties. It's truly what is going to work for you. But don't cut yourself short just going, well, I'm going to settle for 4. I'm going to challenge you to work it to a level that puts you a little bit of an uncomfortable level. Because when you step out of your comfort zone, this is when the amazing things are going to happen, okay? So again, fill your calendar, continue with your customer care calls, and then again, you're going to be making more. Now, of course, you would get a bonus, and what they're saying is because if you consistently add team members in 90 days, if you are constantly talking about your business, if you're proud of what you're doing, you're passionate about your products, you're sharing it with everybody, you're going to have a full calendar, and you're going to have team members. So within 90 days, you could promote to a director if you consistently do this. 8 parties every month. If you have 10 guests at 8 parties, let's just say as an example, 10 buying guests at 8 parties a month, that is 80 new people you are reaching every single month. Out of those 80 people, you will probably have 2 to 6 recruits out of the 80 people that will join your team. So just think, if you are intentionally offering the business and intentionally asking everybody to allow you the opportunity to come into their homes or to pamper their kitchens, you're going to see the success grow. So if I ever say, just keep going, you're doing everything right, just keep going. It means you're really, truly working the business. It's just that sometimes it doesn't happen overnight. You know, we all want everything to happen yesterday. And that's where you have to let your patience set in. You need to reach out to team members and stay motivated. And you got to set goals and have a plan. If you're just doing this with no plan in front of you and you have no, you know, I want to make $375 every month, I want to promote to a director, or whatever your goals are, if you don't have that in front of you, you're just kind of winging it going, well, whatever I get, I get. What's happening is you're doing it more of a hobby. And if you want to treat this like a business, that's when it's going to grow. So you want to have your goals in front of you at all times, okay? So do not get discouraged. I know that April and May sometimes are a little bit more work, but I always tell everybody, you know, there's always light at the end of the tunnel and the gold's at the end of the rainbow. You know, so you just got to climb the rainbow and get over this, and it's going to lead you to the success that you've been wanting. So please don't get discouraged. Reach out to team members, reach out on our team page, reach out to me. I'll work with you one-on-one. I'll help you fill your calendars, whatever it is that you need to do. But this roadmap truly is going to help you to be successful. So I am going to ask everybody to print it off. And then as you finish these, sticker them, star them, date them, whatever, and post on our team page. And then we are going to help to celebrate your success. And that, like I said, the company designed this. This is fairly new. It just came out in the past couple of weeks, and I just got my hands on it in Hawaii. And I just thought that this was such a great tool to use, because I do think it kind of keeps it in front of you to say, this is what I should be doing to be successful in my business. And again, if you're not ready to recruit, we're not trying to force you by any means to do that. So if you're not ready, we still want you to invite them, but you're more than, you know, you could always tell your recruiter, you know, hey, so-and-so wants to join. I'm not really interested in having somebody. And they would join under whoever that person is, and you can help them get started. But again, we will support you wholeheartedly. We will help everybody get trained. And again, this, like I said, this is just a little roadmap to success. So that is all I have for this evening. I tried to make it as quick as possible, but I always ramble. That's just me. You guys know this. This is just Vanessa. So anywho, so tomorrow night is recipe night at my house. My address, I will post online, but it's 217 Green Street in Brockton. Ignore my Easter decorations. I did not have time to take anything down yet, but Easter was just like 2 days ago, so we're good. And when you come tomorrow night, it's going to be a very relaxed environment. We are just going to giggle and make food and just have a great old time. We are all going to be hands-on with the recipes. I have 3 recipes we're going to do. I'm going to talk about some ideas that you could utilize these at shows and give you ways to use it a little bit more versatile. And then I'm also going to have all of us brainstorm ideas on how we could show different ways to do the recipes, maybe some tips about the food we're using, what products would we use, maybe that we don't use tomorrow night. Because we're going to try to do minimal dishes, because I don't want to be doing dishes till midnight tomorrow night. So we're going to do minimal dishes, but we're going to discuss what products we would use. And any products that you've never touched, I'm going to let you touch tomorrow night. We'll get those out. And then we'll, you know, work on cleaning up together. So we will be doing that. I will Zoom that tomorrow night. So I'll put up a link for that as well. So that way, if anybody wants to interact with us, nobody will be muted. You guys could talk just like we are. The recipes are on there. So if you want to make them tomorrow night as we're cooking them, feel free. We can do that as well. But hopefully I'll see a lot of you for recipe night tomorrow night. And on that note, I'm going to get my kids a bath and get them settled. And if you have any questions, feel free to post. And I will put the replay of this up for you. And have a wonderful night.